This is Mitch Wagner for the news show. I'm here in La Jolla, the next town north from San Diego, for the dedication of CalIT2, the California Institute of Telecommunications and Technology, a partnership with the University of California, San Diego, and UC Irvine.
This very, very shiny building will house 900 researchers. What will the researchers be working on? Director Larry Smarr said that just as academic researchers years ago created the internet, the advanced technology that CalIT2 researchers are developing today will become off-the-shelf stuff in the not-so-distant future and help to permit collaboration and communication between groups across continents.
Mm-hmm. So a lot of what CalIT2 is about is injecting software into the myriad of embedded computers that are everywhere in the world, connecting those computers together, creating a more or less intelligent fabric that we live in and interact with. Now it'll take 3, 5, 10 years until it flows out into the private sector, into the marketplace, the way that the web from 10 years ago is ubiquitous today. But it's coming as sure as anything. I think by 2010, this is going to be completely common.
Research facilities include clean rooms used to develop nanotechnology for fighting diseases, including cancer. They wouldn't let me into the clean room because they said I was too schmutzy and needed to wash up. This cute little guy is part of an experiment that Sony is doing at CalIT2 to make its robotics technology more user-friendly. The robot is called a Curio. That's Q-R-I-O. I'll let researcher Fumihide Tanaka explain.
Specifically, through this project, I am interested in the what kinds of behaviors can attract humans or children's interests as possible as or as long as possible.
Okay.
So, and also, if we can build an interactive computer which supports people like teachers for the educational purpose, that would be great.
Okay.
Ideally, Sony wants it to be an entertainment robot,
sure,
home environment.
Another technology being researched at CalIT2 is digital cinema, specifically technology called 4K, which is as vivid and high resolution as a good analog movie, but can be streamed over high bandwidth networks. Applications include entertainment, of course, and also video conferencing that's nearly as good as being there, even international video conferencing. Here you're looking at a trailer for an IMAX movie called Mystic India. Of course, it looks terrible now. I filmed this segment sitting in the 4K screening room with a consumer-grade Panasonic handheld camera, but trust me, in real life, it looked and sounded great.
The big fella behind me is Bear, a 330,000-pound rock sculpture in front of the building designed to create primitive art in the midst of the high-tech environment. This is Mitch Wagner for The News Show.